Hello, everyone, and welcome to my very first Enshrouded build video. So, you know, I've been streaming this for, I would say, a few weeks now, and I decided, since I didn't do a build video for our castle back in closer in the starter area, I guess, I was going to do a build video out in, it's not really the desert, but like the Savannah. I would consider this a Savannah in Imbervale. And yeah, so let's get right into it.
Thank you.
And here we are, the final build for the Savannah home. So I did this a little bit during the behind the scenes, the courtyard I did actually do during this build. I just didn't really show a whole lot of it. But on the outside, I wanted it to look like a small house, kind of like one of the abandoned buildings, just throughout the desert / savanna area. Obviously, water well. Because let me tell you, getting water, whew, is a task. But yeah, very, very simple. I didn't want to go too crazy. I might add later on, like, a couple chairs and whatnot there. But like I said, not too crazy. And then when you enter, this is where it gets wild. So this area, it's just like the crafting, because you know, we're going in and out a lot, and I want the chest to be boom right here. The smelting, the charcoal, the tanner, the, you know, all this stuff just right here. And and here, because I wanted to like do like a little bathroom. This honestly favorite room. I don't know why, I just love it. And another thing about this build is I halfway through, like especially getting done with this area, I realized I really wanted to keep a lot of the raw stone look, and that's what I did here in this bathroom. And I think this is why I really, really like it, because it just, it feels like an actual cave home, and that's what I was going for. This just feels like a basement to me. And then we go out here. I love these. So I did break through like the cliffside. You can actually see where there's more porch area, and that's further downstairs. But yeah, we broke through the cliffside, or I broke through the cliffside, and I just wanted like a nice little cute sitting area, you know, and more tables probably will come here soon. Especially once we get more furniture and stuff unlocked and getting lapis lazuli, which we did get in behind the scenes part 2. And this area is like just your comfort. So resting and, you know, eating and whatever, and just for the like aesthetics. But this, I love this. When we finally got glass, I was like, oh my God, I love these. But I did want to stay true to like the desert / savanna like architecture. So I used really only like the stone furniture or the palm wood furniture. The carpet, not so much. It's just the regular carpet. And then I think I made this room a little bit too big, but I feel like once I get more furniture in here and unlock more from the carpenter, then this place will definitely start to feel more like a actual sitting, lounging area rather than a table. But here, so going back to, oh yeah, like the raw stone look, we come here to the hallway, just random cupboards. But this, I love this. I honestly call this the hall of don't go into the light. But also, just personalized little bedrooms. Because why not? You know, everybody needs their own little bedroom. Their own little furniture. I didn't go too crazy with this. Because hopefully, like, you know, the group will decorate their own room. But yeah, so we got this one. You know, I love these little lanterns. I think they're so cute. And then this is the biggest bedroom. I didn't really mean to make it this big. I'm actually thinking about like making like a secret wall with we just unlocked the hidden door bookcase. I'm actually thinking about putting this like right here. I think that would be really, really cool. But once again, going back to the raw stone look, I like the hallway. I don't know how to decorate it. I'm actually thinking about making some monster trophies and then putting them on the wall and stuff. I think that would be cool. But other balcony, I didn't know how to like truly decorate this balcony. Really, I made these balconies just as like jump off points for gliding and stuff. But probably another table. I'll probably put a table out here, you know, all that cool stuff. But yeah, so that's pretty much it, guys. That's pretty much it for this lovely build video. Let me go and sit in a chair. Can I sit in this chair? Can I sit in this chair? No. Can I? I want to sit. No, we're just going to sit next to it. Okay. Fine. We'll just sit on the rug. Boom. There we go. But I do hope you guys love this video. I really enjoyed this build, and I'm not really super experienced in the Enshrouded like building stuff. But I am happy with this, especially since like this was my first, really truly my first time doing like terrain manipulation and stuff, and I really enjoyed it. Was it a bit of a hassle? Yeah, it was, but I still enjoyed it. So, and I love the stucco look and the desert and the pop of colors of here and there. But I hope you guys do enjoy this video. Thank you for watching.